Hello friends, this is Murtaza Ali Khan and I am bringing to you the review of the new Amazon series Utopia, which is helmed by the famed author of Gone Girl, Gillian Flynn, and it's actually based on the 2013 British series of the same name. This basically will take you back to the good old comic book world, you know, that's been missing, you know, but of late we are seeing a revival there. We know the increasing realism, you know, had, you know, somewhat taken the comic book feel away, and we were talking about more realistic treatments to superheroes, more realistic treatment to the comic book worlds. But now with Deadpool and in the recent times there have been other stuff going on, and with the rated R superheroes also coming with the bang, so comic book feel is returning, and you know, Utopia is a continuation of that. So if you are a comic book lover and if you were missing all that, probably this is gonna, you know, set it correct, and this is a one step forward, a giant leap forward as far as comic book feel you know, motion picture medium is concerned. Gillian Flynn, you know, is very good when it comes to darker motives, when it comes to diabolical subjects, and again she's able to deliver us a very, very interesting you know, series. It's really interesting because it's set in a world wherein, you know, there is a magazine called Utopia which is able to predict pandemic. So, you know, we are living in pandemic times. Imagine a magazine, you know, which is able to predict viruses like Corona, Ebola, Zika. You know, you think of any pandemic and you are able to predict it through this magazine. So conspiracy theory enthusiasts are surely gonna love this series, and it's really wacky, and it's about these comic book fans who want to save the world by, you know, trying to get their hands on this magazine. At the same time, there are other evil people who want to, you know, kill these people and want to get hold of the magazine so that nobody is able to save, you know, the world from the upcoming pandemics. So it's a back and forth cat and mouse game, and there is a very interesting character called Jessica Hyde, which is actually a character in the magazine also, and that's actually a character in the real world also. So that's when, you know, you realize that the comic book is really coming, you know, and you are becoming a part of it. You are getting sucked into that world because the comic book characters themselves are coming alive, and it's done in a very beautiful manner. Yes, there are some, you know, issues in terms of pacing, but probably once it's sorted out, you know, after a couple of episodes, I think it's in a very good space. The only trouble is that if you are not accustomed to watching a lot of gore, a lot of bloody stuff, then you might, you know, not be very willing to, you know, take a, you know, plunge into this world. But if you are a comic book fan, or and if you are okay with violence, and if you like being surprised, if you like the sudden death environment, then Utopia is really something that you will enjoy. The ensemble cast is, you know, really amazing. John Cusack has done a wonderful job. He's really, really, you know, bringing his star-studded, you know, aura to the series, and he's really added a lot of weight, you know, through his amazing screen presence. Rainn Wilson is another, you know, wacky character that you will come across. He really, you know, takes it to the next level. And Christopher Denham, you know, he's really a very, very scary serial killer in this. He's a continuation of all the amazing serial killers that we have seen over the years. So he's another character that, you know, will really take you to the limits. So the rest of the cast also, you know, is able to deliver a very interesting job. It's basically a young cast, so the youngsters will really like, you know, a beautiful balance between these experienced performers and youngsters. So as far as Gillian Flynn is concerned, she's really, you know, able to keep a hook over of the kind of balance that she, you know, is known for, the dark. And there's also humor in it, so the dark aspects as well as humor, you know, balance each other out. Initially this was supposed to be, you know, helmed by David Fincher, but somehow it didn't work out, and that's how the project came to Amazon. And you know, probably the second best person after David Fincher, Gillian Flynn got to helm it, and overall she has done a decent job. Yes, it could have been better. There are some places wherein you feel that probably, you know, it is loosening its focus, its grip, but overall she's able to tie things up really well by the end of the series. So, you know, if you are not too much of a nitpicker, if you are okay with, you know, a little bit fumbles here and there, but you are, if you are all for storytelling, and if you are someone who loves the comic book world, then you will definitely have a nice time watching this. As far as rating is concerned, I'll give it 3.5 out of 5.